Hello, I'm Mr. Arlinger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm doing exposition of Mark 2, verse 18 to 22. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by Jesus, the first anointed Christ of the Most High, living God, Elohim, that dwells within us, called Emmanuel. This is the temple of God. So God lives in his temple, not outside. If you have not a blood of greed inside you, if you are greedy and hypocrite, then he is out and Satan is in. So it's your choice to let God in or Satan in. Free, that is called free will. He was the first anointed light from our Father. And Satguru equal to Christ, Nanak the second. He came in 1469. Gospel according to St. Mark 2:18-22. For once born natural disciples of John and of the Pharisee were accustomed to fast. You know, the John the Baptist, he was witness to the light, but not the light. Witness to the light means this one. Light is inside me, which you can't see. You perceive that there is a light inside me, and which is a soul. Soul you can't see. It dwells in me. So, when you are born, you are a natural person in nature. You know, the animals also have sex and they produce children and all that. Similarly, you also are a naturally born. And when you are born naturally, you are called a natural boy, because you haven't got spirit yet. You haven't had the desire or longing for God. When you develop longing for God, and if God be willing, then he will bestow upon you Holy Spirit, which is common sense, which you can misuse it to make money, as Judas Iscariot did, or you can use it to earn your salvation, or get sealed to serve God. So the once born natural disciples, the root of the word disciple is discipline. Natural boys need to be disciplined through the moral laws of Moses. Otherwise, they will go hayward and cause problem. So, school teachers teach them the moral laws, what is written of the prophets. So, John the Baptist and Pharisees, Sadducees, they were the moral teachers. Whereas John the Baptist was an ideal moral teacher, while the other one, you know, they were hypocrites, but they were telling what to do to their disciples. Disciple means their students. They do what the teacher tells them to do, as Saul was doing what Gamaliel told him to do. No question asked. Otherwise, if he doesn't do, the Gamaliel will proclaim it is a sin. Transgression against the moral law is sin. So, the once-born natural disciple of John and of the Pharisee were accustomed to fasting and prayers. They also said a prayer to Yahweh, who is not inside. He is a mythological. This is not real. It's a mythological. But inside me is the soul of my supernatural father, that is, make me living, is real. Without that, this is useless. So that's why we call it, this is not real. Inside me, what makes me living is real. Came to Jesus and objected. People came to Jesus and objected. Why do the disciple of John and the disciple of Pharisees fast, but your disciples? But they were calling disciples because they were not twice born. Because that the word disciple was common. But Jesus did not have disciples. They were solitary laborers. Each one of us solitary, otherwise he can't enter into the royal kingdom of God through the narrow gate, only meant for solitary. So the Jesus had the twice born sensible laborers, and they did not fast or pray. Remember in Matthew, when Jesus was eating at Matthew's place, these Pharisees came, and they said, "Hey, why your disciples don't pray and fast as those of the John and Pharisees Sadducee?" Then Jesus answered them, you know. Jesus answered them, "Can the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom is with them?" So this is how it is, you know. Jesus is our bridegroom and we are his guest. And he feed us every day, every minute with the gospel treasures that we eat with this ears, and we preach gospel to accumulate them, to put them in our heart. What is in heart should be outside. What is inside should be outside. No hypocrisy. If you are a hypocrite, you can't preach gospel. Jesus answered them, "Can the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom, Christ Jesus, is with them? As long as they have the bridegroom, the Christ, this is the temple of God, the priest of the temple of God is called royal priest, and he is Christ. He is inside me. It is the Christ speaking inside me. The Christ within their hearts are with them, they cannot fast. But the days will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them by these antichrist pope." You know, this pope, you know, has nothing to do with Christianity, because everyone has to give his own account to God. Can pope give your account? Or do we need rabbis anymore? To get rid of the yoke of the rabbis, Jesus gave his own sacrifice to set us free. If you want them back again, then you are good for nothing. So these antichrist pope and his stooges, these dog collar priests and those father, you know, with these long robes, and then they will fast on that day. That's why they do fasting, you know, on prayer and all that, you know, they do in the churches. Let us pray. To whom? They say, "Father in heaven." He is no more in heaven. He is no more alienated. He is inside me. Today, people are not solitary. They are the blind followers of these antichrists. They follow them, you know, as in Ireland, this Catholic and Protestant, Ian Paisley, how he had a following and they were just fighting with each other. They were antichrist following, fighting with each other. If they had knew that in Christ we are solitary and we exercise love called agape, divine love, then they would not have fought. they lead them to sectarian riots. No one sews a piece of unshrunk cloth. Unshrunk mean untouched, unshrunk. You know, when you make a cloth, when they weave the cloth, they put some starch on it. And after, when you want to use it, you know, that cloth, then you normally wash it. And sometimes if you want to color it, then you have to give a modem, what they call modem, you know, that catches the color of the color, make it fast color. Usually it's alum, you know. Sew a piece of unshrunk cloth, New Testament, on an old cloak. Old Testament. You know, Old Testament is the Jewish leaven, which Jesus forbade not to bring Jewish leaven into the church. And also, these are script. Script, dead letters. And Jesus said, when you go to preaching tools, don't take any money in your pocket, no two shoe, no two tunic, no script. That means no Bible in your under your armpit. You should go without Bible. Gospel is written over your heart, not in the Bible. So you should be able to preach gospel. So unshrunk cross, New Testament on an old cloak, Old Testament, as this Bible is. That's why they are confused. They don't know that the Old Testament God is different from the New Testament God. The New Testament God is the Most High, Elohim, loving and merciful. He is like, you know, he has his fold. And anybody who comes into his fold, he gives the protection. And also you have free will. If you want to leave, yes, go ahead, leave. And when you suffer, then you say, hey, I was better off in that fold. Let me go back. If you come back to God again, he will forgive you all your transgressions. He will protect you without any condition. So this is the beauty of our Father. So the building faith is your own efforts. You have to make your own effort to build faith. More you preach, more faith you build. If he does it, if he does, its fullness pulls away the new from the old, and the tear gets worse. That means they are not compatible, Old and the New Testament. Old Testament say, if somebody hits you on one cheek, and hit him on the other, take his teeth out. New Testament say, if somebody hits you on one cheek, present the other. Just the opposite. So they are not compatible. People are highly confused. They don't know what to say, you know, between Yahweh of nature and the natural man full of ego and revenge, with Elohim, our loving and merciful supernatural Father, in which you don't hit at the conscience, you don't hit on the body, but at the conscience of the person. That's why when Jesus was before the chief priest and he was being questioned, Jesus wasn't answering anything, because to tell him, you know, if he won't believe it, because he determined not to believe, he wanted to impose his own views. So Jesus was quiet. Somebody, hey, you don't answer my chief priest. He hit him on the cheek. Jesus asked him, "You, what wrong I have done that you hit me?" So same question we should ask the person, if somebody hit you, what wrong I have done that you hit me? Or ask a friend here to ask him, what wrong he did that you hit him, you know. if he has conscience, then he will beg, he will ask him to forgive him. And that will make him a good friend. That his conscience had been hit and he has repented. So in Jesus, we hit at the conscience of the people, not at the physical body. Likewise, no one pours new wine, mixes gospel that cannot be written down in ink on paper. Gospel is not scripture. It is not letters. It is one you have to think logically. The end product of logical reasoning is logo. And logo sits in your heart because you have thought on logical basis. You have found that one through logical basis, logical reasoning. So it rests in your heart. Nobody can take it away. So the scripture, you know, they are dead letters. They argue in the university, you know, this man written this thing is this, in New Testament is this, Old Testament is this. They confuse, you know, because what apply to flesh, the opposite to spirit. This thing of New Testament is of spirit, not of the physical body. Such as the parable of marriage and divorce. In the physical body, there are two people getting married. After marriage, they are still two. Jesus, they gave them this spiritual marriage to the Pharisees. He said, for this reason, the man is our soul, leaves his mother and father, God, to join the flesh, his wife. Flesh is in the womb of the woman. This marriage takes place, you can't see, but you have to perceive. When they are joined together, soul and flesh, they make one person, not two anymore. So what God has joined together, man should not put it asunder. These abortions are putting that thing asunder, killing lambs of God. And they get scot-free. Mixing that carried cannot be written down in ink on paper into old wineskin. They are not compatible. Gospel and letters are not compatible. So when I go to Oxford University and they are men of letters, and when I tell them gospel truth, they are not capable of logical reasoning. Though, so they won't understand it. They only know dead letters of the books. So they say, hey, Mr. Nidja, we don't come to our seminars. You disturb us. You need to have a degree and PhD or MSc, MA in theology before you can join our seminars. But the others are quite good, you know. And I go there and make contribution and they appreciate. Into old wineskins. People full of the old wine of the letters are scriptures, as the university professors are. They can't take new wine on top. Otherwise, the wine will burst and the skins, for they are not compatible. Such as if someone hits you on, you present the other cheek. And both the wine and the skins are ruined because leading to a much confused person. He's confused, you know. Jesus said, so turn the other cheek. How can I turn the other cheek? Such as soldiers fighting, you know. They say in their, our Father in heaven. First off, he is not in heaven, he is inside. Forgive those and all that nonsense. And then they take a gun and start killing people. Rather, new wine is poured into the fresh wineskins. As Jesus created at Cana Marriage, when all the specks of the old wine were rinsed off. And then Jesus asked them to fill with clean water. Yeah, you can think clearly, no murky, no doubting. And then when you think logically, logically reasoning is the yeast that will create new wine. So when you think logically and you get to the gospel treasures, so that is how you get it. So logo is the gospel treasures. Our Father God blesses you.